Here we are at Don Bosco Secondary School. Welcome to a new school year, and I hope you guys had a great summer vacation. Now we're going to take a few moments here to look at the great history of this school, so why don't you guys just follow me. Don Bosco Catholic Secondary School had a humble beginning. In 1978, the Metropolitan Separate School Board and the Archdiocese of Toronto agreed to a new Catholic high school. The school opened September 1978 in a large portable school at 165 Dixon Road. It was to be under the direction of the Salesian Fathers and named in honor of Don Bosco. At the time, the school had no gym or cafeteria, and all the classes were taught in 26 portables. The portables were crowded, and students and staff had to endure facilities that were often cold, wet, and lacked adequate plumbing. The school situation was reflective of an era when full funding for Catholic education did not yet exist. Life in a portable school was difficult. Often students had to endure rain and/or snow as they moved from portable to portable. However, their spirits were lifted by the promise of a permanent school. In spite of these conditions, the school flourished. The Bosco community became known for its spirit, vitality, and achievements. For 5 years, parents, students, staff, and Salesians campaigned with unwavering conviction to find a more suitable and permanent site for the school. During these years, numerous letters were written and a correspondence with the Minister of Education and the Premier of Ontario was established. Several demonstrations were organized, including a rally held at Queen's Park. Don Bosco's situation escalated to the point that it became a major local issue in the 1981 provincial election. The matter was covered extensively by the newspapers. Finally, through negotiations with the Etobicoke Board of Education, Keeler Mackay Collegiate Institute was purchased and Don Bosco moved to its present location on St. Andrews Boulevard in 1983. Each and every alumni from Don Bosco has contributed a piece of themselves to the school's history, and each of them has a unique story suited to their personalities, which has transformed the school's community. And just as the students, the teachers have also been part of the process. So why don't we look at the first few years as told through the first principal, Father Thomas Mohan.
The start of Don Bosco is really an example what a Catholic school could have been and should be. Don Bosco Secondary School stands as a symbol of the right of Catholic parents. Symbol of the right of Catholic parents to educate their children within the Catholic academic tradition. The school is a memorial of parental determination to claim these rights. This was infectious. That first staff at the Don Bosco was really a staff that sometimes we didn't know exactly where we started off. Bosco has got the best form of pedagogy that we would ever want in a school. Reason, religion, and kindness. You know? And that's what each of that school started out to be. Reasonable, kind, not being charitable with each other. Religion? Yes, because religion always plans way ahead. It gives objectives which are not immediately obvious. Those first few years of Don Bosco, I thought were going to be a school that was going to be absolutely academic. There was a spirit at Henry Carr that got spread down to Don Bosco. They knew they had to learn, that we were going to choose, we were going to make sure that they learned. We had a rule in the park from the students and the teachers that if somebody did not know something, they had to go back and learn it. They just don't skip it and go on to the next. And so we had that spirit, the academic spirit of Don Bosco, was most exemplary. I enjoyed it very much, really. And of course, we didn't have really the great hope of Henry Carr. Why? Because the government at that particular time was determined we weren't going to open Don Bosco. We were going to spread us all around the city. Any place where there was a seat available, which is, of course, Catholic schools are community schools. And you've got to be together if you're going to be a community. And those first 2 years of Don Bosco, really enjoyed it. I think that the staff and students at Don Bosco loved each other as much as I think I've ever seen in the school. We had one long, big portico. The land sloped from Dixon Road back to the park. It was on a hill. And there was during the summer and during the spring and fall, it wasn't too bad. But when the winter time came, sometimes we got to the ice, the kids would slide from one end of the campus way down to the other. It was the only spot we could do to have a school. And so it opened in 165 Dixon. It was advice. I would say every day, first of all, before they come, they've got to find out what Don Bosco is about. Why do you want to come to Don Bosco? You've got to answer that question. That means you've got to know what Don Bosco is about. What are the objectives of Don Bosco? Is that what you want in your life? If you don't want it, don't come. But if you want those things, because I promise you, if you obtain them, you'll have the happiest life, the most productive life that a human being could have absolutely had.
Thank you for joining me on this wonderful journey through Don Bosco's history. My name is Jones Santiago, and we'll see you next time.